Hi guys, welcome to my channel. As you know, Windows 11 version 2.4.h2 has been released and many users who updated that version have faced different issues like slow performance, compatibility problem or even unexpected error. If you prefer to stay on your stable version like 2.3.h2, you can definitely do that. In today's video, I will show you how to block the latest Windows 11 update and stay on 2.3.h2 versions as long as you want. So let's check how we'll do this. The easiest way to stop update temporarily is by using the built-in pause features. Okay, so right click on the start menu and select settings. On the left pane, find and click on Windows update. You will see an option that says pause update with a drop down menu. You can see. So click on it and you will see a pause for 1 week, 2 week and all the way to maximum available duration, that is up to 5 weeks. Once you select for 5 weeks, your updates will be completely stopped for 5 weeks. But after the time is up, Windows will automatically start updating again. If you want more control or you especially want to block Windows 11 2.4.h2 from installing on your system, the good news is there is a way to do that and it is pretty simple. And here I will walk you through it step by step process. Okay, so to do that, you will need to disable the Windows Update service. For that, we need to access to the Group Policy Editor. So click on Start button and type gpedit.msc. Then press Enter. This opens the local Group Policy Editor. In the left pane, under Computer Configuration, you will get Administrative Templates. Now expand this and you will find Windows Component. You need to expand this also. Then you need to look for Windows Update. You need to expand this also. And here you need to click on Manage Updates Offered from Windows Update. And once you click on this, in the right hand side, you need to find Select when preview builds and features updates are received. So once you find this, just double click on it and this page will come up. And you can see Not Configured is selected. You just need to select Enable. Here it says how many days after a features update is released, would you like to defer the updates before it is offered to the device? You can set this up to 365 days maximum. Okay, so let's go ahead and set it to 365 days. Now we can pause the preview and features update starting from the today's date. You will need to enter the year, month and day exactly as it is shows on the screen. That's really important, otherwise it won't work. So let's go ahead and set today's date. Once you have done that, click apply and OK. Now you won't be receiving features update for this machine for up to 365 days, but you don't have to stick the 365 days. OK, you can choose 2 months, 6 months or whatever works best for you. But the maximum is 1 year. OK, now go ahead and type CMD in the search box and run it as administrator. Once the command prompt windows will open, you need to type one command here and the command is gpedit --force and hit enter. This command is important because it instantly applies the policy changes we made, so you don't have to restart your computer. That means your Windows will not install 2.4.h2 for the next year. If you go to the update settings now, and you will notice that updates are paused and it says your organization paused some updates for this device. This means that regardless of what you do here, since the policy is set, you won't receive any features update. Okay, so you can safely say that you will be staying on version 2.3.h2 and you won't be forced to update 2.4.h2 as long as that policy is in place. Okay, if you want to go back to receiving updates, it's easy. Simply double click on the policy you set, then select Not Configured. Once you do that, click on Apply, then OK. After that, you will either need to restart your PC or you can open command prompt. And once again, you need to type gpedit --force to apply the changes without restarting. But if you prefer restarting the PC, we'll do the same thing. OK. Now that we have removed the policy, let's check for update again. When you go back into the settings, and you will see the yellow post sign disappear. Now you will see that the green check mark will come back, and your system is ready to receive the latest features update once more. Now I will show you a way to delay updates for more than 365 days, so you can stay on your current version without getting updates. So if you go back to the group policy editor and look at the Windows update section, on the right side there is another options. You can take a look at select a target features update version, meaning you will stay on that version until you change it, and this can go beyond a year. For example, if you select this, you will be able to stay on a specific version for an extended period, which is especially useful for the businesses that want to stick to one version for a while. So if we enable this, you will see it asks for your operating system here. Suppose let's put Windows 11 and then choose the target version of features update. Let's set it to 23H2. This means you will stay on 23H2, and 24H2 won't be offered to you or forced upon you because you have set it to 23H2. Okay. This policy will now be in place, and as long as it is active, you won't be pushed to a newer version. Now, to make sure the policy takes effects, we will need to open command prompt once again. And the same way, you have to type gpedit.msc /force and hit enter. This will ensure the policy is applied. And that's it. You are now locked into the selected version. You can use this for any Windows build, whether it is Windows 10 or 11, and choose which version you want to stay on. And you won't be forced into a update until you remove the policy. Okay. The same way, if you want to debug the changes, follow this step, then select not configured. Once you do that, click on apply, then okay. After that, you will need to restart your PC. Or if you prefer to not restart, you can open command prompt again, and the same way you have to type gpedit.msc/force to apply the changes immediately. So that's how you can block Windows 11 updates and stay on version 23H2 for as long as you like. Remember, blocking updates for too long may cause security issue. So check for update periodically. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and let me know in the comments if you have any question. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.